Today we are going to show you our semiconductor diode characteristics trainer kit. Order code is 36169. So this is the trainer kit here. This is inbuilt DC voltmeter. This has a dual range, one is 0 to 2 volt and one is 0 to 20 volt. Using this switch we can select the range 2 volt or 20 volt. This is inbuilt DC current meter. This also has a dual range, that is 20 microampere and 20 milliampere. Using this switch we can select 20 microampere or 20 milliampere. This is a 0 to 10 volt DC variable power supply. This is the coarse switch and this is the coarse knob and this is fine knob. This is germanium diode OA79. This is silicon diode IN4001. And there are three resistors, 10 ohm and 47 ohm. This is the main switch to turn on or off the kit. Patch cards and manual are included with this kit. So our first experiment is to study and plot the forward and reverse bias characteristics of germanium and silicon semiconductor diodes. For this we are going to build this circuit here. This is forward bias circuit. So first connect this positive terminal of the power supply to the positive terminal of voltmeter and connect the negative terminal of voltmeter to the negative terminal of power supply. Now from positive terminal of power supply connect the anode of this germanium diode and connect the cathode to the positive terminal of current meter. And connect the negative terminal of current meter to the negative terminal of voltmeter. Now select the range 2 volt and select keep this ammeter range at 20 milliampere. Turn on the key and slowly increase the voltage. So now we can see there is no current, so slowly increase the voltage. And we can see that the current is increasing very slowly. So note down the forward bias voltage and the corresponding current flowing through the diode. Now we will see the forward bias characteristics of the silicon diode. So just connect this to the silicon diode and again increase the voltage very slowly. So we can see that the current has not started flowing yet. So slowly increase the voltage. We can see at this voltage the current is started flowing. So this is the forward bias voltage of the silicon diode. Like this. You can see that the current has now started increasing rapidly. So if we plot the graph from this reading, we will get this type of graph here, and we can see that for germanium and silicon both have different forward bias voltage. Our next experiment is to study reverse bias characteristics of germanium and silicon diode. For this, we are going to build this circuit here. So first, connect the positive terminal of the power supply to the positive terminal of voltmeter and the negative terminal of voltmeter with negative terminal of power supply. Now, connect the positive terminal of voltmeter with the cathode of germanium diode and connect the anode of germanium diode to the positive terminal of the current meter and connect the negative terminal with the negative terminal of voltmeter. Now keep this range at 20 volt and this current meter range at 20 microampere. Now increase the voltage slowly and we can see that a very negligible amount of current is flowing through the diode. This is 16 microampere. Like this. You can check the reverse characteristics of silicon diode like this. Just connect this to silicon diode, that is IN4001, and repeat the previous steps to see observe the reverse characteristics of silicon diode. Next experiment is to draw the characteristic curves of a forward biased PN junction and to determine static and dynamic resistance of the given diode. For this, we are going to build this circuit given here. As in forward bias, the diode offers very negligible resistance. So for security purpose, we will use resistance here. So first connect this anode of the diode with the positive terminal of voltmeter and cathode of the diode with the negative terminal of voltmeter. Now from anode of this diode, connect the negative terminal of ammeter and connect the positive terminal of ammeter with a 10 ohm resistor. Connect the other terminal of the resistor with the positive terminal of power supply and connect the negative terminal of power supply to the cathode of the diode. Now use 2 volt range of voltmeter and 20 milliampere range of current meter. Now turn on the switch and slowly increase the the voltage. Initially, we can see there is no current flowing through the diode. Keep increasing the voltage. We can see now at this voltage around 0.3 volt, the current has started flowing. This is called the knee voltage. Keep increasing this voltage and take the readings of current. Like this. And note down the readings given. Note down the reading in the table that is given in the manual. Now change the resistor from 10 ohm to 20 ohm and again follow the above steps. Note down the voltage and when the current is starting, this is the knee voltage, that's denoted by Vk, and also note down the readings of the current and the voltage. Note down these readings in this table and use this reading to plot this graph here, these two graph here. And from this graph we can get static resistance and dynamic resistance. This is the formula given here in the manual. This is for static resistance and this is for dynamic resistance.